Hello everyone, I am Nikita Murthy, Faculty of Information Science and Engineering, Maharaja Institute of Technology, Mysore. In the last class, we were talking about reliable data transfer. Under that, we are looking at the scenario called looking this scenario under the reliable data transfer, where reliable data transfer over a channel with bit errors. That means we are trying to build a reliable data transfer protocol which has a reliable channel, but there might be a corruption of the packets while traveling through the network. Under that, we were seeing a RDT 2.0. We had seen RDT 2.0. How does the RDT 2.0 works? Reliable data transfer 2.0 means, now when we send the packet, while transmitting the packet from the sender to receiver, if it gets corrupted and the corrupted packet has been received by the receiver, that the receiver, what it does, he will send the positive acknowledgement or negative acknowledgement. If the positive acknowledgement received by the sender will send the next packet. If the negative acknowledgement has been received by the sender, what he does? He will retransmit the packet that has been sent earlier, thinking that the receiver has not received the packet correctly. So here what we are doing, we are trying to stop for a few minutes thinking that waiting to receive the acknowledgement, and then when we get the acknowledgement, based on the acknowledgement we are retransmitting or transmitting the packet. That is why we call RDT 2.0 as stop and wait protocol. We call RDT 2.0 as stop and wait protocol, because here after sending the packet, it will stop and wait for the acknowledgement to receive. Based on the acknowledgement, it takes the next action. Here, if we see stop and wait protocol, it seems like it's completely functional, fully functional protocol, but we are neglecting one flaw, or it has a some major flaw. It has a major flaw. What is that flaw? Can you think of that? Now we are thinking that only while sending the packet from sender to receiver, that may get corrupted. What if the acknowledgement that has been sent from the receiver to sender, while traveling from the receiver to sender, there is also a chance that the packet might get acknowledgement get corrupted, isn't it? Yes, we are neglecting that one. That is the major flaw in the stop and wait RDT 2.0 protocol. That means here we are neglecting the fact that acknowledgement while traveling from the receiver to sender, there is a chance that it may also get corrupted. Now let's take an example. I am speaking to my friend and I am saying, hi, how are you? And when he receives that properly, he will say, yes, I am fine. If the hi, how are you message has not been heard properly by my friend, what he does? I did not hear you, please repeat it again. So now if I, after listening to that, please repeat that, and I will repeat that hi, how are you message again to my friend. But there is also chance that the receiver or my friend saying, I did not hear, please repeat it again, this message is also possible that it may get corrupted. I could not hear it properly because of the network issue. Whatever my friend said, I could not hear. The acknowledgement received by my friend, I could not hear, isn't it? What will I do? Sorry, I did not hear. I will also say, I did not hear, isn't it? That means there is also a chance that while traveling back from the receiver to sender, acknowledgement may also get corrupted. Now, what could be the solution? Can we add a checksum, enough checksum along with the packets to the acknowledgement also? By having the checksum, can we solve this problem? Not fully, because just by adding the checksum, we can only detect the error. We cannot recover from that errors. from the checksum we are able to only detect that bit errors, we are not able to recover that bit errors. But even though if you have recovered, we cannot think of the, or if the packet is only get lost, the acknowledgement packet get lost, we cannot address that problem. And another solution which we could think is, when we could not receive the acknowledgement within a certain time, when we did not receive the acknowledgement within certain time, we will retransmit the data, we will retransmit the packet. But while receiver, when receiving, what can happen, he cannot make out whether the received packet is a retransmitted packet or is it the new packet. Here is the sender, here is the receiver. Here is the sender, here is the receiver. Now sender has sent the packet, here sender has sent the packet. For this packet, receiver will send the acknowledgement. The receiver will send the acknowledgement. While traveling, the acknowledgement may get lost. While traveling, the acknowledgement get lost, or let us say it has corrupted. The received acknowledgement by the sender is corrupted. We are not able to understand whether it is a positive acknowledgement or negative acknowledgement. Now, if we just add the checksum over here, if we add just checksum over here, we are able to only address the, only you are able to detect the bit errors or the corrupted error. We are not able to recover from that. Now, as we have not received the correct acknowledgement, as we are not able to make out whether it is the received acknowledgement or not, what we will do? The sender will try to retransmit the packet. The sender will try to retransmit the packet. But receiver, when this packet has been received, but the first packet has already received, again the sender has retransmitted the same packet. The receiver cannot make out whether the newly received packet is a new packet or is it a new data or is it the retransmitted one. Then what could be the solution? The only solution to this, to have a sequence number. The only solution to this problem is to have a sequence number. Now suppose here, while sending the packet, what we will do? I will just put the sequence number, I have put the sequence number as 0. Now, while retransmitting the same packet, what I will do? I will send the same sequence number, isn't it? While retransmitting the same packet, the same sequence number will be sent to the receiver. The receiver who has received the earlier packet, when he receives the new packet with the same sequence number, what he will think? He will think that yes, the sent newly arrived packet is a retransmitted one, it is not the new data. Next, the sender, while sending the new packet, what he will do? He will put the new sequence number. He will put the new sequence number. When new packet is received by the receiver, he can make out, yes, this is not the retransmitted one, it is the new packet. It has to be added to the data. The protocol that has been revised, the RDT 2.0 that has been revised, we call it as RDT 2.1. RDT 2.1, which provides for the sequence number. So the revised one, which also addresses the retransmitted packets, where it is providing the sequence number solution, that revised protocol we call it as RDT 2.1. As you could see in the diagram, they have tried to show the RDT 2.1 sender finite state machine. This is the sender side finite state machine. Here, as you could see, here the dashed arrow is showing the, here the dashed arrow is showing the initial state, when here it is waiting for the call 0. So here, let me make a note. Here in this protocol, we are only transiting between the sequence number 0 and sequence number 1. When the sequence number 1 is sent, we will again come back to sequence number 0. When sequence number 0 is sent, we will go back to 1. When 1 packet is sent, we will come back to 0. Here we are only considering 0 and 1 packet for the ease of understanding. So here wait for call 0 from above. That means here we are waiting to receive the packet from the upper layer. When that means we are waiting for the packet with sequence number 0. Here when we receive the packet, what we will do? We will send the packet to the next layer. That means RDT send off data. That means we send the data to the lower layer. That means make a packet. Send packet means make a packet of 0. See, here you can make a sequence number. Here we are putting the sequence number for the receiver to understand. Is it the retransmitted one or newly transmitted? Here in the make packet you could see 0 followed by the data, and also we are providing the checksum to detect the errors, and then we are sending it to the lower layer. Next, from the first state, after receiving the packet, we are transiting, where the transition is happening to the next state, where it is waiting for the positive acknowledgement or negative acknowledgement for what? Packet with sequence number 0. Here, if the received packet is corrupt, here you can make out if the received packet is corrupt or if the negative acknowledgement is received, the transition is staying in the same state. There is a loop, isn't it, for that negative acknowledgement or positive acknowledgement for the sequence number 0. It is remaining in the same state when we receive the corrupt packet or negative acknowledgement. Next, what if we receive the positive acknowledgement? If we receive the positive acknowledgement, we are transiting it to the next state where we have to transfer a new packet. That means when we receive next, see the action, when the received packet is not corrupt and then the positive acknowledgement received, we are transiting, we are taking a transition to a new state. What is the new state? Wait for call 1 from above. That means here we are waiting to send the packet with the sequence number 1. Since the sequence number 0 has been successfully sent, we are now have to send a sequence number 1. Next, here when it receives the packet, it has to make a packet. It has to make a packet with the sequence number 1. Here in the initially we had put a sequence number 0. Here we making it a sequence number 1 followed by the data, and also checksum is included to detect the errors. And then when it is, while this is happening, it has to take a transition to the next state where it has to receive, where it has to wait to receive the acknowledgement, positive acknowledgement or negative acknowledgement for this packet with sequence number 1. Here also same thing is happening. When it receives the negative acknowledgement for the packet with sequence number 1, it is staying in the same state. When it receives the positive acknowledgement, when it receives the positive acknowledgement and the packet is not corrupt, it is traveling, taking a transition to the initial state, where again, as I said earlier, here we are only considering only 0 and 1. When 1 is sent, we are coming back again to 0. When 0 is sent, we are going to the 1. That is what they have shown it in the diagram. Now, let us consider the receiver side of the RDT 2.1. As you could see in the diagram, here it is the receiver FSM of a RDT 2.1. It has only two states where it will be waiting for the packet with sequence number 0 and it will be waiting for a packet with sequence number 1. Now, let us try to start with the initial state, which has a dashed arrow. Here, when it receives, look at the upper action, look at the upper action. When the received packet is not corrupt, when the received packet is not corrupt and has a sequence number 0, it was waiting for the sequence number 0, and if it has a sequence number 0, then what we will do, we will extract the data from that packet and we will deliver the packet to the application layer. And then only that much, no, we have to send a positive acknowledgement to the sender, isn't it? That is why we have to create a packet with a positive acknowledgement and send that packet along with that. Now, when this upper action is happening, when we have received the proper packet, we have to take a transition. Since the zero packet is received, we have to wait for the packet 1, isn't it? That is why we have to take a transition from 0, wait for call 0 to wait for call 1. That is, we have to move to the next state. What is happening in the next state? Here, when the received packet is corrupt, what we have to do? We have to send a negative acknowledgement. That is why we are creating a packet of negative acknowledgement also with the checksum here, and then we are sending that packet. Next, again below the action below that, what is there? There also it is staying in the same state. Here there is one more action which is also staying in the same state. What is that? Now here we are waiting for the sequence number 1. What happens if we receive the sequence number 0? We cannot say that we have received the correct packet, isn't it? That is why we have to remain in the waiting state to receive the packet 1, isn't it? This is what they have shown it here. If the received packet is not corrupt, the received packet is correct, but we have received the sequence number 0, but we were waiting for sequence number 1. Here, if we receive a sequence number 0, what we have to do? Even though if you have received the sequence number 0, we have to send a positive acknowledgement to the sender saying that yes, again I have received the packet that has been sent by you about the sequence number 0, but still we are staying in the same state. Why? Because we have to receive a sequence number 1. Now let's come to the below action. Here the received packet is not corrupt and we have received a sequence number 1, and we have received sequence number 1. What happens when we receive the sequence number 1? We'll extract the data from the packet and deliver it to the process, and then we have to make a packet of the positive acknowledgement and then send it to the sender and then come back to the initial state. In the initial state also, yes, here also the same process we are repeating. Here if the received packet is corrupt, what we will do? We will send the negative acknowledgement to the sender, and here we are waiting for the sequence number 0. If we receive the sequence number 1, what we will do? We will again send the positive acknowledgement, but still we are staying in the same state. So in the last scenario, we were only talking about the bits being corrupted. We are talking about bits being corrupted, but there is also a chance that the packet may get lost in the network, isn't it? Yes, in the next scenario we are going to talk about the same, reliable data transfer. Reliable data transfer over a lossy channel. Over a lossy channel with bit errors. Here, not only the packet being corrupted, we are also considering the case of where a channel may lose the packets, a lossy channel. That means, along with the packet error, we are also considering the packet loss in this protocol. The protocol here, initially, what are all the cases we can think about? First, we can think about including a checksum for detecting the errors, retransmitting if the packet gets corrupted, and we can include the acknowledgements to know whether the receiver has received the packet correctly or not, and the sequence number for the receiver to know whether the packet is a retransmitted one or a new packet. So all this has been included in the RDT 2.2. All these mechanisms has been included in the RDT 2.2. So as you could see, they have a bit revised the RDT 2.2 as compared to RDT 2.1. What is the revised thing? What we could see here is the sender and here is the receiver. Just to make out, the sender is sending the packet with the sequence number, and then for this sequence number, the receiver is also sending the acknowledgement. Here we are only concentrating of the positive acknowledgement. Here the for the packet sent by the sender, if it is correctly received by the receiver, he will send the positive acknowledgement to the sender. Here the only revision we could see is the sequence number is also added to the acknowledgement. The sequence number is also added to the acknowledgement. That means when you receive the acknowledgement of sequence number 0, you can make out that the sender can make out that the receiver has correctly received the receiver. The receiver has correctly received the initial packet. When we send the another packet, when we send the packet 1, the receiver will send the acknowledgement saying that I have received acknowledgement 1. This is the finite state machine of the sender side of the RDT 2.2. Here let's start with the initial state where the dashed arrow, where it is waiting to receive a packet with sequence number 0. When it receives the data, what it does, it will create a packet. When it receives the data, it will create a packet with a sequence number 0 followed by the data and also the checksum, and it will send it to the lower layer, and the transition is happening from the first state to the next state. What is the next state? Wait for positive acknowledgement for 0. Here in the RDT 2.1, we were waiting for the positive acknowledgement and negative acknowledgement. Here it has been bit revised. Here we are only concentrating about receiving positive acknowledgement. Now here they have considered two cases. If the received packet from the receiver is corrupt, that means acknowledgement is corrupt, or there is a chance that we can also receive the positive acknowledgement of the sequence number 1 packet, isn't it? Not only the packet being received is corrupt, but also that if the there is a chance that we can also receive the positive acknowledgement for the packet 1. If these things are happening, remain in the same state. Now, if the received acknowledgement is not corrupt and it is the positive acknowledgement for the packet sequence number 0, then move to the next state. What is the next state? Wait for call 1 from above. That means wait to receive for data of packet number 1, packet with sequence number 1. When you receive the data for the packet with sequence number 1, create a packet with the sequence number 1 followed by the data and also include checksum and send it to the next layer. Next, then if this action is happening, take a transition to the wait for acknowledgement 1, wait to receive the acknowledgement for the packet with sequence number 1. Here also there is a chance that if the received acknowledgement is corrupt, or if we receive the positive acknowledgement for the sequence number 0, remain in the same state. Or if the received acknowledgement is not corrupt and we have correctly received the positive acknowledgement for the sequence number 1, then move to the initial state again. Now let's try to look at the receiver side of the RDT 2.2. As you could see in the diagram, this is what the FSM of receiver side of the RDT 2.2 will look like. Here also it has two states, where it is waiting for the sequence number 0 and the other state is waiting for the sequence number 1. Now let's start with the upper action, where you receive the packet and the received packet is not corrupt. When the received packet is not corrupt and you have correctly received the packet with sequence number 0, what happens? Extract the data from the packet and deliver the packet to the correct recipient, and then create a packet of a positive acknowledgement. Create a packet of the positive acknowledgement with the sequence number 0 and then also the checksum and send it to the sender. Next, the transition is going to the next state, where the received packet is corrupt, where the received packet could be corrupt, or if you are waiting for a sequence number 1, But what if you receive the sequence number 0, remain in the same state, and then you, along with remaining in the same state, you have to make a packet of acknowledgement, you have to make a packet of the acknowledgement with the sequence number 0 and then send it to the sender. Here we are still remaining in the same state. But when you receive the packet and that packet is not corrupt, and then you have received the correct packet with sequence number 1, what you will do? You will extract the data from that packet and then deliver the packet, and then you will make a packet with the acknowledgement 1, and then you will send it to the sender, and then you will move to the initial state. In the initial state, you are waiting for the sequence number 0. If you receive the packet with sequence number 1, if you receive the packet with sequence number 1, you have to make a packet of a positive acknowledgement with sequence number 1 and send it to the sender and remain in the same state. Now, in the RDT 2.2, we are only concentrating about acknowledgements or the packet getting manipulated or corrupted. We are not talking about the packet getting lost. Now, the sender has sent the packet to the receiver, and the receiver has sent has not received the packet because the packet has get lost, or the receiver has correctly received the packet and the acknowledgement while traveling back to the sender it has lost. What could be the solution for this? When this sender or receiver can wait for some time, for a specified time, that means we can put a countdown timer. Now, if the sender is waiting for the acknowledgement for certain time, what could be the step? For that means, if the sender, after sending the each packet, he has to start a timer. That means start a timer for each packet. And then that means for every packet that has been sent by the sender, he will start a timer. That means of a specified time. Let's say 1 minute. I have assigned 1 minute for a packet. That means within one minute, if I don't receive the acknowledgement by the receiver, retransmit the packet. That means what would be the next step? Respond to the timer interrupt. That means take a appropriate action. That means within 1 minute, if I don't receive the acknowledgement by the receiver for the sent packet, I have to retransmit the data. That means I have to take some action. That means respond to timer interrupt. After that, what you have to do? I have to stop the timer, isn't it? The third step is stop the timer. That means, how does the countdown timer works? Start a timer for each packet sent. That means for each packet I have sent to the receiver, that means I will keep a time, let's say 1 minute, and then I will wait for 1 minute. If I don't receive the acknowledgement by the receiver, I will retransmit the data. That means I am taking the action, and then after the action has been taken, stop the timer for that packet. Here, the new protocol which has a countdown timer is called as RDT 3.0, which is also called as alternating bit protocol, RDT 3.0, which has a feature of countdown timer, which addresses the issue of losing the packet. It is also called as alternating bit protocol. So, in the RDT 3.0, we are only considering the FSM of a sender side. That is what they have shown it in the diagram, the sender side of the RDT 3.0. Here, let's start with the initial state. Where here, when you receive the packet, or when you receive the data, what you have to do? You have to make a packet of a sequence number 0. You have to make a packet of sequence number 0 followed by the data and the checksum and send it to the lower layer. After sending the packet, what you have to do? You have to start a timer. That is the main important feature of this RDT 3.0. And then move to the next state. And then here we are waiting for a positive acknowledgement of a sequence number 0. If you receive the, if the received acknowledgement is corrupt, and if the, or if you receive the positive acknowledgement of a sequence number 1, wait in the same state, or there is also a chance that a timeout can happen. That means you have waited for some time, and if you haven't received the acknowledgement, that the timeout will occur. If that timeout has occurred, then you have to retransmit the data. That is why when the timeout occurs, your UDT send off send packet, and then that means if the timeout has occurred, again retransmit the data. That is why UDT send off send packet. Here retransmitting the data. After retransmitting the data, for that packet also you have to start a timer and then wait in the same state, because we have to receive the positive acknowledgement for that. And then if you receive the positive acknowledgement, if you receive the positive acknowledgement for the sequence number 0 and that packet is not corrupt, then move to the next state and then stop the timer. Move to the next state. Since you have received the proper acknowledgement, we will stop the timer. Then we are considering for the sequence number 1. Here in the sequence number 1, what is happening? When you receive the data, we are making a packet of the sequence number 1 followed by the data and the checksum. Again we are starting the timer. Here for the sequence number 1, we are starting the timer and then move to the next state where you are waiting for the acknowledgement for that packet number 1. And then if the received acknowledgement is corrupt, or if you receive the positive acknowledgement for the sequence number 0, wait in the same state. Or if you haven't received the acknowledgement in the proper time, what happens? Timeout will occur. If the timeout occurs, retransmit the data, retransmit the packet number 1 and start the timer and wait in the same state. Next, if you receive the proper acknowledgement within time, for the same sequence number, stop the timer and move to the initial state, and the cycle repeats. Here they have tried to also look at the another way of working of the RDT 3.0. They have considered 4 cases and how does the RDT 3.0 responds to that. Let's look at the first case. The first case is operation with no loss. The diagram which you are seeing, it is showing the case of operation with no loss. That means no packet loss has occurred, no packet corruption has been occurred. That means from the sender, send the packet number 0, and at the receiver side, the packet has been received, the packet 0 is received. When you receive the packet 0, send the acknowledgement 0 to the sender. When the sender receives the acknowledgement 0, what happens? He will send the packet number 1, and the packet number 1, when it is received by the receiver, he will send the acknowledgement 1, and when the acknowledgement 1 is received by the sender, he will send again the packet number 0. So that means it is perfectly reliable data transfer. Now let's look at the case of packet loss. If the packet loss occurred, how does the RDT 3.0 show perform? This is how they have shown it in the diagram. Now here also they have sent this packet 0 has been sent, and it has been received by the receiver, and the receiver for the packet 0, he are sending the positive acknowledgement. And then when it received by the sender, what he will do? He will send the packet number 1. While traveling from sender to the receiver, the packet 1 has lost. So for each packet, the timer is set, isn't it? When the acknowledgement is not received for the packet 1 within the time, the timeout has occurred. When the timeout occurs, he will retransmit the packet 1. When the timeout occurs, he has retransmitted the packet 1. And then when it received by the receiver, he is going to send the acknowledgement for that packet 1. Next case which you can think of is the acknowledgement getting lost in the network. That is what they have shown it in the diagram. Here the packet 0 is sent by the sender, it is received by correctly received by the receiver, and the acknowledgement 0 has been sent and it is correctly received by the sender. Now when it received, then the sender will send the packet number 1 to the receiver. When the receiver has correctly received the packet 1, but then what it does, the receiver will send the acknowledgement 1 to the sender. The acknowledgement 1, while traveling to the receiver to the sender, it is lost in the network. When the acknowledgement is not received by the sender in the proper time, the timeout occurs. When the acknowledgement is not received by the receiver, here also the timeout occurs. When the timeout occurs, he will again retransmit the packet 1. The sender will again retransmit the packet 1, and then for that packet 1 also, it is going to send the positive acknowledgement, but that packet 1 will be deleted by the receiver. Now, not only packet getting lost, there is also a chance that the receiver has sent the acknowledgement. While traveling in the network, due to some congestion or any network issue, there will be delay in while traveling in the packet, and the within time the packet has not received, the acknowledgement has not received by the sender, but it is properly received by the receiver, and the receiver has already sent the acknowledgement. The acknowledgement is not lost, but due to some delay it is not received by the sender within time. Let's look at that case, what happens. Now the packet 0 has been sent by the sender, the receiver has received it and sent the acknowledgement for that packet number 0, and when it receives the packet number 0, the packet 1 is sent by the sender. Now packet 1 is received by the receiver, but the acknowledgement 1 that has been sent by the receiver, it is not received by the sender within time. Within the specified time, the acknowledgement 1 is not received by the receiver. But when it is not received by the sender in the proper time, the timeout occurs. When the timeout occurs, it will again retransmit the packet 1. It is again retransmitting the packet 1. Again, here in the receiver, it is again received the packet 1. So what happens when it receives the packet 1? It will again send the acknowledgement, positive acknowledgement for that packet 1. But it will, at the receiver side, it will delete that duplicate packet. Then, when it receives both the acknowledgements for the same packet, it will again send the new packet. The sender will send the new packet. So, with this, reliable data transfer protocol, building a reliable data transfer is finished. Thank you.